Hey guys, hey, here's today's video. If you remember in one of my previous posts, I installed this gate on the driveway of the farmhouse. Well, over time, this post here, it's a 6-inch post, it started to sag in the ground because it was just, I dug it with the backhoe, put the post in the ground and backfilled it. So over time, the weight of the gate, because it's 14 feet long, the post started to sag this way. So I dug it up. I went and I reset into cement, 42 inches deep, and thinking I'm great until I found out one problem, and I'll show you right now. Get you guys close right here. A little more. There's the gate right now in the open position, or almost all the way open, and because that gate's 14 feet long, here's my problem with the post. I have a lot of deflection. Let me demonstrate. I hope you can see that, but there's a lot of deflection in that fence post, which is making my gate not swing level. And I want to put an opener on it because I'm tired of getting out of the truck every time to open and close the gate. So what I'm going to do is redig that post out. I'm probably going to dig out with a postal digger around it, then grab the backhoe and try to pop that post out. So I'll take you guys along for the journey here. So let's see how things go. All right. Hey, I dug down with a manual postal digger. A good, I'm gonna say 20 inches or so, maybe not quite in some spots. I'm just trying to like loosen up this cement block that I have poured. Like I said, it's 1,000 pounds of cement that I put in there, if you go by the bags. And it's gonna be a pain neck to get out, but I have to get it out. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna go grab the backhoe. Put a chain on the front bucket and try to wiggle this thing loose like a tooth, I guess you can say. So let me get the backhoe going and we'll be right back. Well, here I go. I'm going to try the rear hole first and see how it goes. Maybe I can swing it this way a little more easier. Maybe the pole's going to snap in half. I really don't know, but let's see what happens. I got rid of the old post. I put it over the hill. There's the hole, and here's my new one. Yes, I bought a 35-foot telephone pole. I cut it into thirds, and now I have three fence posts, gate posts. I think it's 13 inches in diameter when I measured the bottom. So I'm gonna redig this hole, clean it up a little bit, kind of caved in a little. I'm gonna go deeper, a little wider, and I'm gonna buy more cement and do it one more time. So let me keep digging. It's in. Let me get rid of the backhoe and get this leveled off before I get some cement poured. Okay, here we are, day number two, because I ran out of daylight yesterday and it was raining out, so I figured I'd wait till today, which is Sunday morning. I have 12 bags of cement. I had two other bags that I had left over, so that's 14 bags of cement, like 80 pounds a piece. And the pole is set. It's kind of temporary bracing right now because the thing weighs a ton. I'll get this cement and then I'll fine tune the levelness of it. So let me get digging, or let me get mixing, and we'll see how it goes. All right, I think I'm done. I ended up using 15 bags of mortar. Cement mix. You can see it's all done. Sorry about my shadow. I got a piece of conduit in because I will be adding a gate opener. I'll clean up my mess, let it set up for a day or two, and we'll mount the gate on it and see what the difference is. And I guess that'll be probably part two. So anyways, that's it for today. Thanks for watching.